What is the most ground swallow me up embarrassing moment that's ever happened to you? That time I screamed at a woman over poo. My little village has a small annual dog show. We normally enter our little dog, who is one friendliest dog, waggiest tail, and dog the judge would like to take home in the past. This year she was unfortunately in season, so we didn't enter to prevent any fuss from the other dogs, but took her along to watch. Halfway across the park she decided to poo, and I suddenly realized I'd forgotten a bag. There were loads of other people with dogs around due to the show, so I wandered away a little to ask someone for a bag. I turned back, and to my horror, a lady was picking up my little dog's mess. Not wanting to feel like one of those a-holes that doesn't clean up, I ran towards her to advise her she didn't have to do that because I was going to get it. Instead, in a sort of panic, I waved my arms and barked in, "Oh, that's my P.O.O." Please note that I did not say, "That is my dog's poo." She physically jumped, then turned a deep red. She sort of mumbled an apology, dropped the poo, and marched off with her dog. It was at that point that I looked to my left and saw my dog's poo sitting a few feet away from a lady's dog mess that she was attempting to pick up. I think about this at night sometimes.
I used to wear glasses, hearing aids, braces, and had severe cystic acne. My doctor put me on a Cotton for the acne, and it made my face insanely dry. One day a few weeks after starting the medication, my friend made me laugh hard in class. It cracked the skin on my cheeks, and my face bled in the shape of my smile like Heath Ledger's Joker scar. I was an abomination.
I was 15. Went to an outdoor center with my classmates where we camped overnight and did some activities over 3 days. Anyway, we had a fashion show where all the boys dressed as girls. So the girls dressed me up with a short skirt and whatnot slash crop top. Well, in Ireland it's pretty cold at night in October, so there I am in my miniskirt freezing my ass off waiting for the fashion show to start, and we go up on a table in front of all my classmates, and my boxer shorts are loose and my small, cold, retreating penis is visible at close proximity to my whole class. The cool guy in my class shouts, "It's like a penis, only smaller." And I died a little bit inside while people laughed, and I heard a few audible ahs and accompanying sympathetic female faces. The instructors quickly got me down off the table, to their credit. Anyway, that moment stuck with me for a long time, and I actually had a bit of trouble with my penis image for a while until I realized that actually I'm perfectly average.
I ran into an old coworker at McDonald's. Our tenures had overlapped by about a month, and that was several years ago. He recognizes me and calls me over to his friends and tells them this is the nicest guy I have ever met. In the next 3 minutes, I called him by the wrong name and asked him how he liked the job he'd never worked at. It was pretty clear that I hardly remembered him. I was so embarrassed that I got my McDonald's to go and ate it in my car. I'm midway through my burger when him and his friends walk up and get into the car directly facing mine. We made awkward eye contact while I had my food in my hand, and then they drove off. FML.
My favorite one was an account of an event on the work forums. A manager was working through a transaction with a couple. Whenever the man was asked the question, his wife would answer. He asked, "Does she ever let you speak for yourself?" The wife responded with no. Not since his stroke.
It was my birthday and we were sitting at the kitchen table. It was my two sisters, dad, and grandma. We were just passing out some cake and my dad asked if anyone wanted whipped cream, and I said, "Rub whipped cream on me, daddy." I have never once in my life called my dad, daddy. I'm not sure if it matters, but I'm a guy, and it was for my 23rd birthday.
I'd been seeing this guy for about 3 weeks or so, and he was staying with me for a couple of days. It was early enough that I wasn't quite comfortable with bringing poop into the relationship, as if there's ever really a good time, and so when I started to feel some intestinal distress, I asked him to go to the shop down the street and pick up some wine to have with dinner. He was fine with it, went downstairs, and gave me some blessed minutes to relieve myself. It was AS for the ages, periods will do that to you, so sending him away was definitely the right call. I went to clean myself up, and no toilet paper. None on the roll. None under the sink. The only place I knew I had some was in the back room, where I stored all the non-perishable stuff, tins, kitchen roll, bleach, that sort of thing. Well, at least I was alone. I waddle down the hallway, holding my cheeks apart so as not to make a mess, and I'm about halfway to the back room before I hear a little voice from behind me, what are you doing? Turns out he'd been to the shop in record time, got back without me noticing, and was sitting on my couch watching me do the Kansas shitty shuffle down my hallway, and I'd been presenting my S-Merde to him like some kind of tub girl mating ritual. That was not how I had anticipated introducing butt stuff into our relationship.
Went to dealership and test drove cars, went to sign for car, reached into pocket, in went through pocket to skin, 6-inch rip in my favorite jeans, thought nobody had noticed but cheek hanging out and felt relieved, returned to dealership for oil change 3 mL later, salesman. I see you got new pants.
In a noisy room, someone was aching, "Are you okay?" Resting dead face overload, but because it was noisy I thought they were asking, "Are you gay?" Being the straight person I am, I said no. They asked why and I explained.
Happened in grade 9. To know why, but me and my friends would play this stupid game where we would try to sneak up on each other and slap the back of our heads as our way of saying hey. I spotted my buddy Reese at the end of the hall and snuck up the best I could and wound up a home run slapper. He noticed last second and ducked. I ended up slapping the S out of my teacher's boob as she turned the corner. F you for making me remember this OP. Edit, this got more attention than I thought it would, ha. Some people have been asking what happened after, so here it is. After the slap, it felt like time was frozen. Kids in the hall all just stopped what they were doing, and the teacher just kinda stood there in shock. I was so embarrassed I cried. In the hall. Surrounded by kids for my grade. Then I got sent to the principal's office where I got a 1-day in-school suspension for hitting a teacher. I think the punishment was so light because the teacher felt sorry for me. The phone call to my parents explaining what happened sucked. My mom was just disappointed in me, in some ways that just made it worse, and my dad just kept laughing. I got called booby for 2 years. I'm 23 now, but my friends still bring up that story. And it too, please stop calling me booby.
I was deathly afraid of public speaking in high school. When I had to give a speech in front of the class, my legs would shake and I would sweat profusely every time. We had to give oral book reports to the whole class in my senior English class. I'm sitting in my chair, legs crossed, sweating with anticipation, when the teacher calls my name, Fanasiphon, you're up. I let out a deep breath and go to stand up. I forget to uncross my legs, so I trip. But I don't just trip, I stumble. I try to regain my balance, but instead I pick up speed. I tumble for about 10 feet before I finally fall. I get up as the whole class stares at me. I slowly walk up to the front of the class and say, well, the speech can't get any worse now. That moment helped me overcome my fear of public speaking though. Since then, I've given multiple speeches in front of large crowds with no problem.
Something similar happened to a girl in my class. This is back in middle school, so you can imagine the embarrassment she must have endured. But it was funny as hell. She was called to the front of the class for one reason or another. Everything is normal, walking up the aisle between two rows of desks and BAM. She catches her foot on a desk and faceplants. Dropped like a sack of potatoes. I feel bad, but I still laugh about it sometimes.
Short backstory, I have epilepsy. We discovered I have epilepsy after I had a full-on, tonic-clonic seizure for the first time when I was standing in front of my locker in the 6th grade. It was the first one of my life, and my body didn't know what to do, so I ended up peeing my pants. It's the only time I've ever lost bladder control during a seizure. Fast forward to the 10th grade, I was in class talking to a new kid, who I just so happened to have a crush on. I had told him my name, and a girl turned around, took one look at how we were sitting together and said, "Aren't you the girl that peed herself in middle school?" He never talked to me again.
In middle school, I used to have a bad habit of chewing on these pens that had sharp tips and came on red, black, and blue ink. Can't remember the brand, but they had a gray body and a see-through little window to see the ink left. Anyway, what I didn't know was that the tube/body was slightly pressurized, and one day during class I bit too hard on the pen, making it burst into my mouth. My teeth, tongue, and lips were stained blue for days, and everyone went around saying I gave a smuff head.
It took me a long time to grow into myself. I was bookish, I wore sweater vests, I had one of those sun-colored change necklaces, I genuinely thought it might make me look cool, and I hairsprayed my Ross Geller haircut. I was called helmet hair due to my overuse of hairspray. I had a crush on this one girl who was very popular, but she was nice to me a few times, so I kept up the dream. One day she has a note passed to me in class, everyone saw it, and I hid it in my desk until I could get home and read it alone. I raced home and rushed into my room, then opened the note. In the note she said she wanted to ask me something but was too embarrassed, so could I come talk to her? My heart fluttered, and for about 12 hours I believed I was this close to having a girlfriend. At school the next day my friend told me it was probably a trap and to forget about it, but she was nice to me so I persisted. I walked up to her and said we should talk. She motioned that we should go talk in private away from her friends and our classmates, but I insisted she just ask me. Her, so I heard you really like NSYNC. Me, yeah. I love them, I just got the CD last weekend. Her, so do you want to go see them with me? Me, I'd love to, I'd been wanting to ask you out. Her. Wait. You're not gay? She wanted me to be her gay friend. I was not slash I'm not gay, I just liked NSYNC. Edit, this was in 6th grade. We were children. Yes, at 30 I realized that your music tastes don't dictate your sexuality.
Damn dude. Reminds me of a story. I was on a sports team in college and had a class with one of my teammates. I sat behind him and would F with him during class, like tickling his ear with my D, no just kidding, with my pen or whatever. The guy-girl ratio was like 1:10. Anyway, maybe a year or so later, I'm at the park and ride into one of the girls in class, and we start chatting and catching up, and she asks me if I'm still with that guy. I was so F confused, having pretty much forgotten about the class by this point, and told her I wasn't gay and neither was my friend. She told me that all the girls in the class had crushes on both of us, but the fucking professor told them that we were gay lovers. I'm still pretty mad about it. As an aside, I mentioned the ear tickling thing because that's the only reason I could think of that anyone would assume we were gay lovers. TLDR, damn speech professor Hiroshima blocked me and my friend. Edit, the professor was a female and I got engaged last month, so it all worked out. Could have gotten laid when I was 20 though.
I used to wait tables. During a busy Sunday post-church lunch rush, I had to make a sundae for a table in the very back corner of the restaurant. I get to the table and the entire party starts laughing. I'm standing there holding the sundae, super confused. I look down and realize that I had somehow managed to get a large amount of whipped cream directly over my crotch while preparing the sundae. It was nowhere else on me. Just my crotch. All I could do was put the sundae down, say oh my gosh, and speed walk back through the entire restaurant to clean myself up.
When I was younger, I was arguing with my dad and called him a fun sucker. Except I got my consonants mixed up and called him a son effer in front of my whole extended family. Edit, not sure who gilded me, but thank you for the silver lining to reliving this chalkboard scratchingly cringy memory.
First bikini, Canadian lake with 16-year-old boys in the cabin next door. I was 15. In love. They take a week before asking if I want to try water skiing. 0.002 seconds standing. Face plant. Bottoms slowly sink in the crystal clear water. When they come back around to help me into the boat, I reply, I don't think water skiing is for me. Swam back to shore in my life vest. Never water skied again. Life advice, learn water sports in a one piece.
In high school, I was hanging out with my group of friends at lunch. One of our friends walked up wearing a suit and started talking to one of my other friends. A few moments later, he says, okay guys, I'm heading out now. I'll be back tomorrow. So I replied excitedly, all right man, have fun. He gave me the weird skull slash look of betrayal I've ever seen. Somehow it slipped past my radar that his girlfriend had developed a super rare disease and died inside the time span of a week. All my friends were looking at me with the widest eyes as he walked away, and in a chorus everyone was like, D-U-U-U-U-U-U-U-U-D-E.
I was 13, and my family and I were on a skiing holiday. My parents had decided to sign me up for lessons, so that my dad could get some good skiing in and my mom and sister could relax and drink hot chocolate. My sister had broken her wrist a few weeks prior to leaving, and my mom isn't really a winter sports fan. I had been throwing myself down mountain slopes with about as much grace as a brick, with the tutor occasionally griping about said demeanor, and was exhausted. We had time for one more run, so we all waddled over to the T-bar machine. This imaginatively named device is so called because a metal bar, shaped like an upside-down T, hooks below your butt and drags you upwards so you're not constantly climbing for 10 minutes and skiing back down in a few seconds. Somehow, my jacket got caught on the bar, which knocked me to the ground. This is not the embarrassing part. It then dragged me along the snow, past where I was supposed to ski off, and carried on along a very icy patch towards the mountain where it would turn back. Still not the embarrassing part. The embarrassing part was when the rough ice dragging under me somehow managed to pull down my ski pants, thermals, and underwear, exposing my bare ass to an entire slope of people and giving me a nasty ice/friction burn all down my thigh. Also, I was yelling my head off to get someone to stop the machine. A lot of people saw. I was helped up and off the ice, and skied down to the bitter lift to take me back down to the hotel. I cried the entire way down. The real kicker was getting back, telling my family this story, while still sobbing through wounded butt and wounded pride, and having my dad and sister howl with laughter while my mom desperately tried to comfort me.
I was walking with my friends from the dorms to a restaurant or something and, deciding to be silly, started doing this little skippy hop type walk lane gag for a laugh, but Noom was laughing. We were at the age where guys laugh at every stupid thing their friends do, so I stopped to turn around and see what was up. Before I could turn around though, I noticed that there was this guy who was somewhat disabled walking in the opposite direction, coming towards us. One half of his body was atrophied and partially paralyzed or something. I don't know what was actually wrong with him, and this caused him to walk with a type of limp very similar but less exaggerated than the skippy hop I was just doing. We made eye contact and I just looked at the ground and heard one of my friends say, "What the F are you doing?" in this tone that makes me cringe to this day. That was almost a decade ago. On the upside, this was so cringy, if that word is even appropriate, that I think I'm dead inside and can't feel embarrassment anymore.
My birthday party, about 15 years old. Kid knocks on door, I answered. Kid's front tooth is green like from rot, it was a temporary cap or something. I just stared at him and he said hi, I said tooth. Pretty sure we both were humiliated. We did not retain friendship.
That kind of happened to me, once. Cashier asked me when I was due. I did happen to be pregnant, but only like 5 weeks along, so I wasn't showing. I'd had my first kid not too long before, they're 13 months apart, so the hormonal havoc of post-pregnancy and early pregnancy led to me grumpily declaring on the way home that I'd never wear that shirt again.
So I had a crush on a girl back in 10th grade. We pretty much flirted with each other, and she told me via MSN that she would like a hug when she came back to school. She was sick for like 2 weeks straight. So when the day came I hugged her. It was super awkward. I hugged her for like a minute straight, and she calmly asked if I would let go of her. That minute felt like an eternity and felt embarrassing as F. After like 11 years it still makes me cringe when I think about it.
I ran into someone I knew from high school at the DMV and talked to him while I was waiting. I got called up and I took care of everything I needed to do before he did. As I was leaving, I told the guy, it was cool seeing you, good luck with the wait, due to the fact that there were 15 to 20 people in front of him. He heard it as, good luck with the wait, which was something he was always sensitive about. He looked at me pissed off slash confused and said, what did you just say to me? To which I sloppily attempted to explain by saying, you know, the wait. There's a bunch of people in front of you, or something like that. It was very embarrassing.
I've awful depth perception. And this one time my friend and I were waiting to cross the road and a bus was turning and for some reason I was convinced that it was gonna hit us. So I grabbed my friend to try and save her, but ended up just cupping her boob. While the bus didn't hit us and all the passengers just stared at this weird kid cupping this girl's boob. Who then started beating on me with her backpack once she got over the shock. I still think I saved her life though.
I had something similar happen, was walking with my much shorter friend. Go to cross the street and some guy comes flying up to the left turn lane opposite us. I assume he isn't going to stop so I throw my arm out to stop my friend. I don't know why, he was a grown man capable of seeing it himself, but he came up to about shoulder height on me. I elbowed my friend in the face and knocked him on his ass in the middle of the street. Then I looked and the left turner was completely aware of us so he was waiting, watching. Laughing at the fact I just hit my friend.
Sitting around the kitchen table with newish boyfriend, boyfriend's mom, and dad in the living room. He's filling out a form for a sleep apnea test because he snores like a bear at night. Most of the questions he needs to ask other people because they happen while he is sleeping, i.e., does your snoring wake your partner? Question comes up, do you suffer from impotence? And I immediately answer nope. Cue the slow head turn of the mom and boyfriend, plus the immediate laughter of the dad in the next room. Felt my face go cherry red as I sank deeper into my chair. That's how they found out we were sexually active.
I've posted this nightmare before, but here goes. I was in high school and heavily involved in drama and acting. I was looking for things to audition for outside of school. My mother found an audition for a Renaissance fair. She insisted I audition, as I was being super picky. I did not want to at all. I ended up agreeing. Flash forward, she tells me auditions are in costume so she bought me a really cheap-esque costume from an iParty-esque website. The audition was at a really waspy country club. So I show up in costume. I immediately want to die. I enter the country club and I have no idea where the audition is. There's a ton of people in there and they are staring at me and laughing like I'm a joke. I am literally almost in tears. Finally I ask a worker slash server slash I have no idea where the auditions are. He gives me directions that make no sense so I wander this place for what feels like forever until I find the room. I enter, and the panel looks at me, repressing their laughter. I want to die at this point. They say I am definitely looking the part slash prepare for the audition. I was given an audition form and told to fill it out. I asked for a pen. They couldn't find one, so one guy takes this really expensive pen out and gives it to me to borrow. He says he needs it back, as it's really expensive. I leave the room, panic slash weep, and flee the country club with this guy's super expensive pen. F that S. TLDR, I showed up to a Renaissance fair in a cheap S costume. Got laughed at, and stole a guy's expensive pen. Edit, the audition was not in costume. I was waiting to go in with about three other actors who were not in costume. Cringe.
What about you? Tell us your story in comment section and don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel.